فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله الذي صير الدين مراتب ودرجات وجعل للعلوم وجعل للعلم به أصولا ومهمات، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله حقا، وأشهد أن محمد رسول الله صدقا. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. أما بعد، this is inshallah going to be our last explanation of the kitab فضل الإسلام, authored and written by the noble Imam شيخ الإسلام محمد بن عبد الوهاب رحمه الله تعالى. سم.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وبه نستعين. باب فضل الإسلام وقول الله تعالى: اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا. وقوله تعالى: قل يا أيها الناس إن كنتم في شك من ديني فلا أعبد الذين تعبدون من دون الله. وقوله تعالى: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وآمنوا برسوله يؤتكم كفلين من رحمته. وفي الصحيح عن ابن عمر رضي الله عنهما أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال: مثلكم ومثل أهل الكتابين كمثل رجل استأجر أجرا فقال: من يعمل لي عملا من غدوة إلى نصف النهار على قيراط فعملت اليهود، ثم قال: من يعمل لي نصف النهار إلى صلاة العصر على قيراط. فعملت النصارى، ثم قال: من يعمل لي من صلاة العصر إلى أن تغيب الشمس على قيراطين. فأنتم هم. فغضبت اليهود والنصارى وقالوا: ما لنا أكثر عملا وأقل أجرا. قال: هل نقصتكم من أجركم شيئا؟ قالوا: لا. قال: ذلكم فضلي أوتيه من أشاء. وفيه أيضا عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال: رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: أضل الله عن الجمعة من كان قبلنا. فكان لليهود يوم السبت والنصارى يوم الأحد، فجاء الله بنا فهدانا ليوم الجمعة، وكذلك هم تبع لنا يوم القيامة. نحن الآخرون من أهل الدنيا والأولون يوم القيامة. أخرجه البخاري. وفي تعليقا عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه قال: أحب الدين إلى الله الحنيفية السمحة. انتهى. وعن أبي بن كعب رضي الله عنه: عليكم بالسبيل والسنة، فإنه ليس من عبد عليه سبيل وسنة ذكر الله ففاضت عيناه من خشية الله فتمسه النار، وليس من عبد على سبيل وسنة ذكر الرحمن فاقشعر جلده من مخافة الله تعالى. إلا كان كمثل شجرة يابس ورقها إلا تحاتت عنه ذنوبه كما تحات عنه هذه الشجرة ورقها. وإن اقتصاد في سنة خير من اجتهاد في خلاف سبيل السنة. وعن أبي الدرداء رضي الله عنه قال: حبذا نوم الأكياس وإفطارهم كيف يظنون سهر الحمقاء وصومهم. ومثقال ذرة مع بر والتقوى ويقين أعظم وأفضل وأرجح عند الله من عبادة المغتربين.
The author رحمه الله الشيخ محمد بن عبد الوهاب رحمه الله تعالى, he opened his book with basmala and he sufficed himself with it, following the sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in which he used to do in his murasalat wa mukatabat, the letters that he would write إلى الملوك to the leaders and others. The author رحمه الله says باب فضل الإسلام, and what he intends by this is stating and mentioning the things that Islam is distinct and unique with. The asal of fadl, it comes from ziyada, extra. So the author here is trying to explain to us المحاسن التي زاد بها الإسلام على غيره, the good things which Islam has extra over other religions. The author rahimahullah mentioning the virtue of Islam with him not mentioning the reality of it. He doesn't even tell us what the reality of Islam is. The reason he did this is so لِتَتَشَوَّفَ النُّفُوسُ إِلَيْهِ, so that the soul and the person finds the drive and the love towards it. وَتَتَطَلَّعَ لِمَعْرِفَتِهِ, and that the person wants to know about it. And this is something which is min sunan al-Arab, is from the Arabs' norms and customs in their speeches, which is to place forward the virtue of something. تَقْدِيمُ فَضْلِ الشَّيْءِ, to place the virtue of something. إِذَا كَانَتْ حَقِيقَةُ مَكْشُوفَةً مَعْلُومَةً, especially if that particular thing that's been spoken about is well known already. And this is what Abu al-Fadl ibn Hajar al-Asqalani mentions in Fathul Bari, that Al-Imam al-Bukhari didn't define what ilm meant. He only mentioned the virtue of ilm. And Hafiz ibn Hajar mentions it there. So placing something's virtue at the first chapter or at the beginning without mentioning the reality of that thing, the reason for that is تشوف إليه, that the people love it. And the second is, but that's with the condition that the thing that you're going to be speaking about has to be known. It has to be well known to the people before that. Islam is already known to the people. Especially the fact that we studied what? ثلاثة الأصول, and we studied قواعد الأربع. You now have an understanding of what Islam is about. Then the author rahimahullah, he mentions 8 evidences to fulfill his purpose of the heading. The first evidence, and each evidence we're going to mention, what is the dalala, I mean the dalala of it. How is he trying to extract the ruling from it? Each one. The first one is اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم. The way that the author is trying to extract from this first evidence is in 3 ways. أولها, the first is اليوم أكملت, today I have completed for you. فبلوغ الكمال فضل, something to reach its completeness is a virtue. When something becomes complete and it is finished, this is غَايَةُ الْفَضْلِ. And the fact that Islam is complete, فَكَمَالُ الْإِنسَانِ دَالٌ عَلَى فَضْلِهِ مِنْ جِهَتَيْنِ, and Islam's completeness, it indicates its virtue from 2 ways. Number one, the meaning that we already gave you, which is completeness itself, to be complete is a virtue. And the second is كون مكمله هو الله سبحانه وتعالى, the one who completed it is Allah, and that's a virtue itself. The second evidence that the author brings is, اليوم أكملت, I said it shows it from, I said, the author is using it for three reasons. The first one I mentioned. The second reason why he uses the ayah is the part where Allah says, وَأَتْمَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعْمَتِي, and I have completed my blessing unto you. And the best blessing that a person can be bestowed upon is نِعْمَةُ الْإِسْلَام, the blessing of Al-Islam. And so that's from its virtue. That is from the greatest, أَجَلُّ نِعَمِ الْإِلَهِيَّةِ, is from the greatest godly blessing. وَأَعْظَمُ الْمِنَنِ الرَّحْمَنِيَّةِ, And the third way in which the author is trying to take from this ayah, الْيَوْمَ أَكْمَلْتُ لَكُمْ دِينَكُمْ is وَرَضِيتُ لَكُمُ الْإِسْلَامَ دِينًا. From the virtues of it is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's pleased with Islam. وَمَا عَدَاهُ, and anything other than it, Allah is in hate towards it and has enmity towards it. That's why Allah says in another ayah, وَمَنْ يَبْتَغِ غَيْرَ الْإِسْلَامِ دِينًا فَلَنْ يُقُبَلَ مِنْهُ وَهُوَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. That's the only religion which is accepted. Everything other than that is not accepted, and the person who comes with it, the Day of Judgment is destroyed. The second evidence that the author uses from the eight evidences is, قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ إِن كُنْتُمْ فِي شَكٍّ مِّن دِينِي وَدِلَالَتُهُ عَلَى مَقْصُودِ تَرْجَمَتِي. And the way that the author is trying to take the ruling from this verse to prove his heading, which is Babu Fadl al-Islam, is where Allah says, قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ إِن كُنْتُمْ فِي شَكٍّ مِّن دِينِي, my religion, which is Islam. From the virtues of Islam is the one that's been worshipped is who? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ إِن كُنْتُ فِي شَكٍّ مِّن دِينِي فَلَا أَعْبُدُ الَّذِينَ أَعْبُدُ. Here is referring to who? أَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ, I'm worshipping Allah. We worship Allah. That's a virtue. This is from the virtues of Islam, the worshipping of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Ibn al-Qayyim says, هَرَبُوا مِنَ الرِّقِّ الَّذِي خُلِقُوا لَهُ فَبُلُوا بِرِقِّ النَّفْسِ وَالشَّيْطَانِ. They ran away, هَرَبُوا مِنَ الرِّقِّ الَّذِي خُلِقُوا لَهُ. They ran away for the servitude which they were created for. فَبُلُوا, they became tested with what? Servitude for their nafs and shaitan. So you're blessed to be able to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that's a virtue. This is fadlul Islam, the virtues of Islam on you. The third evidence that the author is using is, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَآمِنُوا بِرَسُولِهِ يُؤْتِكُمْ كِفْلَيْنِ مِنْ رَحْمَتِهِ. And the dilala that the author is trying to extract from this verse is the great reward that's connected to Islam is what shows how virtuous it is. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, يُؤْتِكُمْ كِفْلَيْنِ مِنْ رَحْمَتِهِ. Three things are mentioned here. The first one is, يُؤْتِكُمْ كِفْلَيْنِ مِنْ رَحْمَتِهِ. The second one is, وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ نُورًا, Allah will place for you light. And the third one is, وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ, and Allah will forgive you. That is the great reward that's connected in that particular verse which the author is using. The fourth evidence that the author brings is the hadith that Imam al-Bukhari narrated min hadith ibn Umar radiyallahu ta'ala anhuma, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَثَلُكُمْ وَمَثَلُ أَهْلِ الْكِتَابَيْنِ. And what the author intends from this hadith is, before I go into that, the author says, وَفِي الصَّحِيحِ. The author says, وَفِي الصَّحِيحِ. And this usage of the word وَفِي الصَّحِيحِ in the authentic is two meanings. The first one is, إِرَادَةُ كِتَابٍ مُصَنَّفٍ فِي الصَّحِيحِ. It's referring to a authentic book that this hadith was taken from, like Sahih al-Bukhari and Sahih Muslim and other books. The second is, when the scholars say it, they mean iradatu jinsi al-hadith al-sahih. They mean that this hadith itself is authentic and it has met the conditions of authenticity. The author's usage of this hadith, what he intends from the hadith, is the part where the hadith says, ذَلِكَ فَضْلِي أُوْتِيتُهُ ذَلِكَ فَضْلِي أُوْتِيهِ مَنْ أَشَاءَ. This is my virtue, I give it to whoever I will. So that in the hadith, it specifically mentions the word fadl, the virtue. in which I give it to whoever I will. The fifth evidence that the author is using is Hadith Abi Huraira radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, that the messenger said, Adallallahu anil jum'ati man kana qablana. This hadith, it's narrated by Bukhari and Muslim, but the wording is the wording of Imam Muslim. And the dilala, the way that the author is trying to use this for the heading, the chapter, which is Babu Fadl al-Islam, is نَحْنُ الْآخِرُونَ مِنْ أَهْلِ الدُّنْيَا. We are the last people of this dunya. وَالْأَوَّلُونَ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. But we are the first, the day of judgment. So when the hadith says نَحْنُ الْآخِرُونَ, it means we are the latest ones. آخِرُونَ وُجُودًا مِنْ أَهْلِ الْأَرْضِ. We're the latest. آخر الزمان is when we come. And we are the last of generations. And we're the last of nations. But we are, in terms of virtue, we're the first. الأولون يوم القيامة. The early ones, the day of judgment. The sixth evidence that the author uses is the hadith. أَحَبُّ الدِّينِ إِلَى اللَّهِ. The religion that is most beloved to Allah is الحنفية السمحة. الحديثية السمحة. The author attributed this to the Sahih. He attributed this hadith to the Sahih. He says ta'liqan. And it mu'allaq means, this hadith is narrated by Imam al-Bukhari mu'allaqan. And according to the muhaddithin, the scholars of hadith, mu'allaq means ma saqata min mubtada isnadihi fawqa al-musannifi wahidun aw akthar. It's when Bukhari drops his teacher or more. So this hadith is mu'allaq, and the author mentions it. And the hadith which are in Bukhari, which are mu'allaq, are not of the conditions of an Imam al-Bukhari. But the author did mention the chain of narration for it and its connection in his kitab Adab al-Mufrad, min hadith Ibn Abbas radiyallahu ta'ala anhuma. The dilala of this particular hadith, أحب الدين إلى الله الحنيفية السمحة, means the fact that Islam is referred to as حنيفية في الاعتقاد. It's a religion that is حنيفية. It is diverted from shirk towards tawheed in its belief. سمح في العمل. And the word سمح means اليسر والسهولة. It's easy, simple in its actions and application. That's a virtue. And that's the religion Allah loves the most. And this is the religion of Al-Islam. And the reason why Allah loves Islam is because it's a religion that combines two things which He loves. حنيفية في الاعتقاد, سمح في العمل. It's upright, steadfast in its creed, in its aqidah. And it is also سمح في العمل. And in its action, ease and simplicity, it's what's in it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves that. And the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for something is a virtue, it's a fadl. And that's why the author used it. The seventh evidence that the author brought forward is Hadith Ubay ibn Ka'b radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, which is mawqufan min kalamihi, is the statement of Ubay. And we said mawquf means what? When it's a statement of a companion. أخرجه ابن المبارك في كتاب الزهد. Abdullah ibn Mubarak narrated in Kitab al-Zuhdi. Ibn Abi Shayba narrated it in his Musannaf. وسنده ضعيف. Its chain of narration is weak. And the author is trying to use from it for this chaptering of his two things. The first is فَإِنَّهُ لَيْسَ مِنْ عَبْدٍ عَلَى سَبِيلٍ. There is not a person upon a path. وَسُنَّةٍ a path. ذكر الله, who remembers Allah, ففاضت عيناه, his eyes water, من خشية الله, from the remembrance of Allah, فتمسه النار, in which the hellfire will then touch him. No, it will never happen. So he's trying to say from the virtue of Al-Islam is, it prevents a person from what? Entering the hellfire. The second thing that the author is trying to use from it is when the hadith says, وَلَيْسَ مِنْ عَبْدٍ عَلَى سَبِيلٍ وَسُنَّةٍ ذَكَرَ اللَّهَ فَقْشَعَرَّ جِلْدُهُ مِنْ خَشْيَةِ اللَّهِ إِلَّا كَانَ مِثْلُهُ مِثْلُ شَجَرَةٍ يَابِسَ وَرَقُهَا فَبَيْنَمَا إِيَا كَذَلِكَ أَصَابَتْهَا رِيحٌ فَتَحَاتَّ عَنْهَا وَرَقُهَا إِلَّا تَحَاتَتْ عَنْهُ ذُنُوبُهُ كَمَا تَحَاتَّ عَنْ هَذِهِ الشَّجَرَةِ وَرَقُهَا. That from the virtues of Islam here, that it eradicates and it gets rid of sins of the slave. So two things is what he's trying to take from this hadith. Number one, from the virtues of Islam is that it prevents a person from entering the hellfire. وَيَمْحُوا ذُنُوبَهُ, and it also wipes away from him his sins. The eighth evidence that the author brought, which is the last, is hadith Abi Darda radiallahu ta'ala anhu mawqufan min kalamihi. It's also the statement of who? Abi Darda radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Ya habbadha nuh nawmul akyasi. Ibn Abi Dunya narrated in Kitab al-Yaqeen. Abu Nu'aym narrated in Kitab Hilyat al-Awliya wa Tabaqat al-Asfiyya. Abu Nu'aym al-Asbahani or al-Asfahani, however you wish to say it. Wa isnaduhu al-da'if, his chain of narration is weak. But what the author tries to use from this is what? Anyone who does an action of obedience and righteousness with the goodness of Islam with him, which is taqwa, and certainty that his righteous deeds will be multiplied. The little actions that he came with will be increased because of the good Islam which he came with. And his Islam will be raised, so his righteous deeds will be raised and it will be multiplied and it will be made a lot. And this is because of the virtue of Islam, that the action was actually multiplied for him in the first place. Ikhlasul amal, sincerity in the action, وَالْمُتَابَعَةِ لِلْرَسُولِهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَّلَمَ, and following the messenger صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَّلَمَ in the action. Ibn al-Qayyim says in his Nuniyya, وَاللَّهُ لَا يَرْضَى بِكَثْرَةِ فِعْلِنَا لَكِنْ بِأَحْسَنِهِ مَعَ الْإِيمَانِ فَالْعَارِفُونَ مُرَادُهُمْ إِحْسَانُهُ وَالْجَاهِلُونَ عَمَوْا عَنِ الْإِحْسَانِ. Allah is not pleased with a lot of our deeds. That's not what He's pleased with. لَكِنْ بِأَحْسَنِهِ مَعَ الْإِيمَانِ, but He's pleased with good actions. Not the quantity, but the quality. With belief, lakin, with iman. فَالْعَارِفُونَ مُرَادُهُمْ إِحْسَانُهُ, the ones who know, who are smart, who are clever, they intend the excellency in the action. وَالْجَاهِلُونَ, and the ignorant ones are blind from the excellency. They're focusing on the quantity.
باب وجوب الإسلام. وقول الله تعالى ومن يبتغي غير الإسلام دينا فلن يقبل منه وهو في الآخرة من الخاسرين. وقوله تعالى إن الدين عند الله الإسلام. وقوله وأن هذا صراطي مستقيما فاتبعوه ولا تتبعوا السبل فتفرق بكم عن سبيله. قال مجاهد السبل البدع والشبهات. وعن عائشة رضي الله عنها أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال من أحدث في أمرنا هذا ما ليس منه فهو رد. أخرجاه. وفي لفظ من عمل عملا ليس عليه أمرنا فهو رد. وللبخاري عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم كل أمتي يدخلون الجنة إلا من أبى. قيل ومن يأبى؟ قال من أطاعني دخل الجنة ومن عصاني فقد أبى. وفي الصحيح عن ابن عباس رضي الله عنهما أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال أبغض الناس إلى الله ثلاث: ملحد في الحرم ومبتغ في الإسلام سنة جاهلية ومطلب دم امرئ بغير حق ليلفق دمه. قال الشيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية قدس الله روحه قوله سنة جاهلية يندرج فيها كل جاهلية مطلقة أو مقيدة، أي شخص دون شخص، كتابية أو وثنية أو غيرهما.
أي في شخص دون شخص.
أي في شخص دون شخص، كتابية أو وثنية أو غيرهما من كل مخالفة لما جاءت به المرسلون. وفي الصحيح عن حذيفة رضي الله عنه قال: يا معشر القراء استقيموا، فإن استقمتم فقد سبقتم سبقا بعيدا، فإن أخذتم يمينا وشمالا فقد ضللتم ضلالا بعيدا. وعن محمد بن وضاح أنه كان يدخل المسجد فيقف على الحلق فيقول فذكره، وقال أنبأنا ابن عيينة عن مجالد عن الشعبي عن مسروق قال عبد الله يعني ابن مسعود رضي الله عنه: ليس عام إلا والذي بعده شر منه، لا أقول عام أخصب من عام، ولا أمير خير من أمير، لكن ذهاب علمائكم وخياركم. ثم يحدث أقوام يقيسون الأمور بآرائهم، فينهدم الإسلام ويسلم.
The author, rahimahullah, He chaptered this chapter to clarify hukm al-Islam, the ruling of al-Islam, and that it is wajib. And he means when he says al-Islam here, al-Dinu alladhi bu'itha bihi Muhammadun sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the religion in which the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sent with. The word wujub here, it means mutalabatul khalqi, is to request the creation forcefully, biltizami ahkamihi, to submit and to adhere to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's rulings. Fil khabari, in issues of aqidah related and tawheed, and also issues related to fiqh. So ahkamun fil khabari wa talabi. Then the author, rahimahullah, this chapter in that he wrote, he brought eight evidences to support it. The first evidence he brought is, وَمَنْ يَبْتَغِ غَيْرَ الْإِسْلَامِ دِينًا فَلَنْ يُقُبَلَ مِنْهُ الْآيَةِ. And the way he's trying to use this ayah is that there is a severe warning, وَعِيدٌ, severe warning, مَنْ يَبْتَغَى, the one who looks for, غير الإسلام دينا, who looks for a religion other than Islam. And warning necessitates destruction and loss. And a warning will only come to what? It will only occur for two things. ترك واجب, if the person leaves off a wajib, أو فعل محرم, or if the person does a haram.